आई एम डॉक्टर विष्णु कुमार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन, JBA, लर्न। टुडे आई डिस्कस एक्सटर्नल फीचर्स ऑफ डॉगफिश या स्कूलेडॉन। फाइलम कोडेटा, सब फाइलम वर्टिब्रेट्स क्रेनिएटा, सीरीज पिसीज, क्लास इलेस्मोब्रेंकियाई, सब क्लास सिलेजी, सुपर ऑर्डर सिलेओकोडी या प्लूरो ट्रिमीडा मेटा, ऑर्डर लेमिनिफॉर्मिस, फैमिली कैरकेरिनियाडी, साइंटिफिक नेम स्कूलेडॉन, शेप साइज एंड कलर्स। डॉगफिश या स्कूलेडॉन हैज ए लॉन्ग लेटरल कंप्रेस्ड स्पिंडल शेप बॉडी टैपरिंग एट बोथ एंड्स। द फुल क्राउन स्पेसिमेन measures from 30 to 60 centimeter in length. The color of the body is dark gray above and pale white beneath, while the portion of the caudal fin are more or less dark. Body surface is rough due to backwardly directed spines of placoid scales embedded in the dermis. स्कूलेडॉन एक्सटर्नल फीचर्स। एक्सटर्नल फीचर्स, एक्सटर्नल स्नॉट्स, आईज, लेटर लाइंस, फिन्स, डोर्सल फिन्स, मीडियल वेंट्रल फिन्स, कॉडियल फिन्स, पेट, लेटरल कॉडियल फिन्स। डिवीजन ऑफ बॉडी, द बॉडी इज डिविजिबल इंटू हेड, ट्रंक एंड टेल, थ्रो देर आर नो डिस्टिंक्ट boundaries between these regions. First, head. The head is strongly compressed dorsoventral and is produced in front into a wedge-shaped snout of rostrum. Trunk. The trunk is almost elliptical in transverse section. Its thickest part lying in front of the middle of the body. The trunk gradually tapers behind into the tail. Tail. The tail is laterally compressed and is bent upward at a small angle and fringed with a caudal fin. Such a tail is known as heterosecial tail. Fins. Dogfish is provided with two sets of fins, which are flattened expansions of the skin supported by cartilaginous rods and horny fin rays. These are unpaired or medial fins are paired lateral fins. Medial fins. The medial fins are two dorsal fins, a ventral or anal fins and a caudal fins. The first dorsal fin is large and triangular in shape and is situated a little in front of the middle of the body. It has a basal lobe. The second dorsal fin is also triangular in outline but is very small and is situated midway between the first dorsal and the tips of the tail. The caudal fin extend along the dorsal and ventral surface of the tail in the median line and forms a dorsal and ventral lobe. The dorsal lobe is very much reduced and forms only a low rise along the greater part of the upper surface, but the ventral lobe is well developed and is divided into two parts, the anterior part being much larger and more extensive than the posterior. The ventral or anal fins is situated in the mid ventral line about 5 cm in front of the caudal fin, more and less opposite the second dorsal. Each of the two dorsals and the ventral fin are produced behind into long and narrow fleshy processes called basal lobe. Male Indian dogfish in ventral view. Lateral fins. The lateral fins are paired pectoral and pelvic fins. The large pectoral fins originate from the ventrolateral margins of the body immediately behind the gill clefts. The pelvic fins are much smaller than the pectoral fins and arise close together from the ventral surface at the junction of the trunk and tail. In the male scolodon, the middle part of each pelvic fin is produced into a dorsally grout, stiff rod-like clasper intermittent organ used during copulation. All the fins are directed backwards, a feature which is advantageous in forward progression. Eyes. On each side of the head is a large circular eyes. Each eyes has two poorly formed immovable eyelids and nictitating membrane located anterioventrially. The pupil is narrow and ventricular. Scolodon right eyes structure. Upper eyelid, vertical pupil, nictitating membrane, lower eyelids, router, tegumens. Body aperture. The following important aperture are present in of the body surface. First, mouth. On the ventral side of the head is a wide concentric mouth. It is bounded by upper and lower jaws. These jaws are with one or two row of sharp backwardly directed teeth having smooth not scat as for holding and tearing the prey. In catching its prey, the shark bearing its jaws into prey by raising the snout and thrusting the mouth forward. Nostrils. On the anterior side of the mouth are present two centric apertures, the nostril leading into olfactory sac which do not open into the mouth cavity. A small fold of skin from the anterior edge partly covers each nostril. The nostrils are only olfactory and have no respiratory function. Gills cleft. Behind the eyes are situated a series of ventricle slits, five or in each side, called branchial or gill clefts. These apertures lead into the gill pouches and then into pharynx. These are respiratory in the function. Cloacal aperture. The cloacal aperture is an elongated median opening at the root of the tail between two pelvic fins. It leads into the olecra, into which the intestinal and urinary and genitally duct open. Anus lies anteriorly and in the colica, and a cone-shaped papilla bearing urinary pore in female and urine genital pore in male located behind the anus. Meibomian pores. There is a pair of oblique situated on the elevated papillae on either side of the colica. These are the Meibomian pores. Through these pores, the coelom communicates with the exterior. Caudal pits. At the root of the tail, just in front of the caudal fins, is a small dorsal and a ventral shallow depression, the caudal pits. The caudal pits are the characterized features of the genus dogfish Scolodon. Lateral line and pores. A fan line runs on either side of the body, extending from the head to posterior end of the tail. This is called the lateral line. It marks the position of an underlying canal which runs along each side of the body and contain special receptor organ. The lateral line canal extends internally into the head, where it branches into several canals. At intervals, these canals open to exterior through minute pores. Ampullary pores. On the head and snout open several groups of the minutes ampullary pores of the respector called ampullae of Lorenzelli. When pressed, they exclude mucus. Sexual dimorphism. In the male, the inner margin of the pelvic fins bear a pair of rod-shaped copulatory organ called clasper or myxopterygia. They are modified part of the pelvic fins. Each clasper is a stiff rod-like appendage having groove on its dorsal surface which leads into a cavity. The siphon beginning at the base of the clasper. Skin. The body is invested by an outer lethary covering called skin or integuments. In dogfish, the skin or integuments consist of two layers in outer ectodermal, epidermal and an inner mesodermal dermis. Epidermis first. The epidermis is composed of many layers of epithelial cells and amongst which are interspersed numerous unicellular mucus glands excreting mucus from lubricating the body surface. Innermost layer of cell rests on a basement membrane and called structum germinativum. Dermis. The dermis comprises dense alveolar connective tissue mixed with smooth muscle fibers, blood capillaries, pigment cells and nerves. Dermis of scorium is divided into an outer layer having few loose fibers called the structum laxum and an inner layer having compact fibers called structum compacticum. Just below the epidermis are found pigment cells, the melanophores or chromatophores. The dermis is firmly attached to the underlying muscles. In a fresh specimen, the skin is slimy, but in preserved specimen, the slimy mucus is generally removed and the skin becomes rough. This roughness of the skin is due to the presence of closely lying minute dermal denticles called placoid scales, which are arranged in regular oblique row and forms of exoskeleton of the shark covering the entire surface of the body and even parts of the fins. Function of skin. In dogfish Scelidon, the skin serves the following functions. Like a wrapper, it protects internal organ against mechanical injuries. Secretion of slimy mucus makes body surface slippery and difficult to catch by predators, minimize friction in locomotion and resist entry of microorganisms into body. Its coloration impart camouflage at the fish blend with slippery surface of water when seen from below and with the dark bottom when seen from above by predator. Skin receptors help in reacting to change in the surrounding. Thank you.